go with this one, sir. This one, what you call it, recording. After our session, sir. Jatin, sir.
Okay, sir. Okay, no issues.
Sir, no, go ahead, sir. Salman, sir.
Oh, sir. Good morning, sir. Good morning, students. Welcome to online webinar on CFD organized by the Department of Mechanical Engineering, ASL College of Engineering. I would like to introduce our resource person, Mr. Kevin. He is a senior CFD engineer at Nexon Solutions. He got graduated from Anna University and he completed his post graduation from Hindustan University and he is currently pursuing his PhD from Anna University. He started his career as a CFD engineer in data patterns, where he has done extensive work on changes in the design of pumps, valves and seals. Later, he has joined as a senior CFD engineer in Nexon Solutions, where he has worked on Newtonian fluids, pseudoplastic fluids, and yield stresses on the. So he has worked in few R&D projects like shell and tube heat exchangers with nanofluids, and passive cooling technologies for BMW i3 lithium ion batteries. He has got extensive knowledge about the CFD. He has published few national and international papers on his name. The Sir Devin sir, welcome you for this session. We are happy to have you for this session, sir. I hope the students will get a lot of extensive knowledge about the CFD from your side, sir.
Sure, sir. Sure. Thank you, sir. Actually, from
yes, sir.
Yeah. So I'll start from here, sir. Good morning, students. Currently, we have around 33 students. That's a good strength, actually. So this is the first time I'm seeing that around 14 students have joined the session by sharp 10. So that's very good.
Sir,
yes, sir.
Few words regarding our chairman, sir, and the principal. I want to speak regarding this, sir.
Sure, sir. Sure, you can speak, sir. After that, I will continue.
Afterwards, you take the charge of this one, sir. Okay.
Sure, sir. Sure. Thank you.
Because they have given a very good opportunity, sir. So I am very pleased that okay to speak about our chairman, sir, and the principal. And all presence here in the pandemic situation. Thank you for joining us at the online webinar in CFD. Now we are coming for the chairman, sir. Actually, he is the youngest and the dynamic. And our Sharma Ahmed sir Garu and the multi-faceted personality who brings to a Islamia group in its continuous act of success here. You all are well known about this one. Okay. For providing a quality education with a team spirit for the student and the sir is a trustable source of inspiration with the hallmark practice of a teaching and a learning process here. Our chairman sir Garu is a qualified HR professional and a certified corporate of a trainer here. And not but the least, sir is a doctoral research scholar in a human resource of a management and sir's specialization in a behavior of a sciences. And sir having many paper published on his name, okay. But our college, we know that the college was established in 2008. The college has grown of a leaps and a bounds under the chairmanship of a Mr. Ahmed Salman Ahmed sir Garu, and the Islamia Engineering College is a well on his way or to achieve the excellence in imparting education at a professional level and making a ready of a worth of a engineering of a application thought here. Now coming to the principal, sir, we are well known that the principal, sir, is our Department of Mechanical Engineering. Dr. Mohammad Masood sir Garu is a renowned scholar, and our principals are having got a 24 years of teaching experience in engineering college. And he started his career is from the lecturer in a as a lecturer in a MJCET. Okay, before taking up inspiration of a he is worked in a SWC Saudi Arabia. After servicing of 4 years, he sir have came back to our India, and sir worked as a professor as well as a director research and the development. Under sir guidance, 20 PhD scholars have carried out their research work, and sir published around 40 research paper international, national and the conference here. and sir have got achieved a guided of MBA accreditation and the NAC accreditation and also the ISO certificate. Sir established of a advance of a R&D centers in the area of a advance of a internal combustion of a CFD. The same thing sir also have the sir have did in advance of a internal combustion of a CFD analysis with the ACT of a funding, and sir developed a internship cell and a incubation center, also organized many seminar and the guest lectures, industrial visit and the model exhibitions and the FD program. And sir having a membership like of a FIE, MIST and the Society of a Automotive of a Engineers here. Now I am not but the least, I am very thankful to the our team of a Mr. M. A. Rabbani, Mr. Muhammad Bahuddin and a Mr. M. A. Salman Khan sir, who have success and given a good support to conduct the online of a seminar of a on a webinar on a CFD. And now I request of a Mr. Jabin Jay sir, of a senior of a CFD engineering of a from the Nexon of a solution to over to sir, you can start.
Okay sir, sure, I'll take it from here. So once again I just want to thank department as well the whole management for giving me this opportunity. So guys, I hope my voice is clear to all, and again myself Jevin. Before starting my session, I just want to check my voice is clear, okay, to all. If yes, please put yes so that we can start. I just want response from everyone. Others, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Good, good. Okay. So guys, actually, so far from March, okay. So I have given my presentations to so many colleges, including VIT. Likewise, so many top colleges have given presentation. But good to see that, as HOD sir mentioned, most of the third year students joined sharply by 10. That's a very good thing, okay? Because if you are given with some time schedule, you are supposed to follow that. Right? So we can start, guys. So today I cannot assure you that what time I'll end, okay? But maximum it will take 2 hours, as that was the time which is given to me, okay? And I don't want this seminar to be like I'm teaching and you hearing, okay? I want to share most of the industry things with you. I hope it is clear for all. So Sajit, kindly check. So I just want to share my industrial experience with you and what are the areas where students is lagging and what is the scope for mechanical students in future. So I just want to share everything. So I just don't want the seminar to be like I'm speaking and you hearing. I just want this seminar to be more than just a seminar, okay? Fine guys. So as introduction is given regarding me, currently I'm working for NextGen as well. I'm doing my doctorate in the area of nanofluidic heat transfer and microchannel heat sinks for BMW i3 cars. Okay, so this is my research area as well. I'm proficient in answers fluent.
Sir, you can video you can open sir here.
Ah, sure sir, sure. Yeah guys, I hope my video is visible. So yeah, so I'm currently doing my doctorate as well, working as a CFD engineer, and I'm proficient in ANSYS Fluent, ISPAC, ISM CFD. A lot of things are there, NXCAD, CATIA, SOLIDWORKS, so many things are there. And day to day basis, we work on so many softwares because HCL, you know, on deputation from NextGen, we are engineering consultants. So we are supposed to have a touch on so many things. I'll mute all. So that is what we do day to day in industry. So the thing is, I just want to mention one important thing, and I want to ask few questions to you so that I can start with my session. Okay. Guys, so far in my tenure, I have been in interview panel. Okay, so in HCL as well, next gen data patterns, I have been in an interview panel. Minimum, I have interviewed so far 120 students. Okay, minimum of 120 students. But so far, I can't even remember a single student who is capable of answering my basic questions, very basic questions. Okay, just assume a student comes from PG, you know, with the post graduation or graduation, even with experience, when we ask some few simple questions, they can't answer it. So that is the situation.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Tell me, sir.
Sir, sorry for disturbance, sir. Actually, you can close your video also, because due to what happened here, our net getting slow and your display is also not clear. You can close the video.
Sure, sir. Sure.
If okay, thank you.
Okay, guys. So just a minute. Okay, guys, so I hope it will be clear now. Okay, fine. So guys, is it clear now?
It's very clear, sir.
Good. Okay, fine. So the thing is, I took interview for nearly 120 students minimum. Okay, so but so far I cannot even remember a single student name. Usually if you are in an interview panel, we can remember, okay, this student is good, this student, but so far I can't even remember a single student who can explain me a very basic things in engineering. Okay, so this is the situation of mechanical engineers in this generation. So why I am pointing this is from industry side. Actually, 2 days before, I was reading an article which is by CC Tech, okay, a famous online cloud CFD software. The CEO of the company mentioned that I'm very sad that most of the mechanical engineers cannot be employed in a concern in CC Tech. Okay, that is because of lack of skills. We cannot agree, right? Because students are going through 10th grade, 12th grade. After that, doing 4 years of intensive course in BE Mechanical Engineering. But he is simply telling that we cannot employ the students because they are not having the required skills. But the fact is 100% real, okay? Because in industry, I personally cannot go for a student who cannot explain me Newton's first law or third law of thermodynamics or Newton's law of cooling, okay? These things are very basic principles you will be reading from your second year. So if a student cannot explain me those things, then definitely my company or any company cannot afford to take that student, okay? Because he did not study those things in 4 years, then how can we give him training? Okay, so that is the fact which companies we are facing problem. Okay, so this is the major problem which is faced in a mechanical industry. That is why there is lot of unemployment in a mechanical field, so many things. Okay, Muhammad Shohib. Okay, every reaction there is, that's fine, good. If you are strong in that, that's good. So guys, this is the first thing which I want to tell you. Okay, so the second thing is the scope for mechanical engineers in present and in future is very high. Okay, why I'm telling is most of the companies are going to start their plants and research centers in India. As well, India is going to start its own things for electric vehicle. It is getting prepared. Okay, so definitely after this lockdown, 6 months from now or 1 year from now, there is going to be so many job opportunities for mechanical engineers in three domains. Okay, I just want to mention in three domains. One is manufacturing, another one is design, another one is R&D. It is like CFD and CAE. Okay, so these are the major three areas. There is going to be opportunity in mechanical industry. Why I am telling this is, nobody can be proficient in all three. Okay, definitely you are going to select one, whether manufacturing, whether design, or whether analysis. It is CFD or FEA. So in today's session, we are going to see CFD as well FEA both. Okay, CFD as well FEA. So because if I simply go on like CFD, this is what we are going to do. Definitely you will not understand the scope. You will not give your attention. So I just want to mention, lot of job opportunities are going to be in the field of manufacturing, design as well R&D, FEA and CFD. So today we are going to select CFD and FEA, and we are going to see so many things. Okay, and guys, industry can select you. Even if you are a fresher, we can select you when you have a basic knowledge in these domains. Okay, so this is the current situation. So we can go to our presentation. Okay. Okay, guys. I hope my screen is clear now.
Clear, sir. Clear.
Ah, okay, okay, okay. Fine, fine. Okay, guys. So the thing is, guys, please don't give me request for annotations and all. Just listen to what I say. Fine. So guys, so this is what CFD is all about. But I'm not just going to explain all these wordings and all. Okay. I just want to tell you some important things. So the main thing is, we have three methods for testing. Okay. Can anyone explain me what are those? Basically, we have three methods, because whatever the industry is, whether it is product based or whatever it is, we are supposed to test a product before it goes onto the market. Okay, so we have three methods of testing methodology. Can anyone explain me? No need to unmute, just put in the chat. Three methods of testing a product. Can anyone explain me? Any one method? Material quality assurance. Not strength. No. Okay, guys, I'll tell you. Okay, the first thing is analytical approach. Okay, the first thing is analytical approach. I'll change my color. The second thing is experimental. Okay. The third thing is numerical. Okay, guys. So these four thing are the methodologies which is available in the industry for testing the product. For example, if you go first, let me go for experimental. Okay. Two decades before, it's like 20 years before or 10 years before, most of the companies were relying on experimental methods. Just to check their product. For example, if you want to check the crashness of the car, what they'll do is they'll manufacture the entire prototype, they'll crash it and they'll test it. Okay. After that, what happened is due to some advancements in mathematical approach and so many things, analytical thing came into play. But what is the problem is analytical approach can only be applied to some simple things like, for example, if there is some small square or the model is of some conventional geometry, then you can apply analytical approach. For example, if your car is something like this, I'm just telling you, if your car is something like this, what we usually do in analytical approaches, we divide these things into some conventional shapes, okay, so that we can apply our analytical approach here, okay. Experimental approach is very costly, analytical approach, complex models cannot be done. After that, in last 10 years, 5 to 10 years, what happened is there is a boom in numerical methods, okay. There is a boom in numerical methods, that's what you will be studying in your third grade and all, okay. I mean, third year and all. So the numerical approaches, by using a numerical approach or numerical method or CFD or FEA, you can solve any complex products, okay. Any complex shapes can be done, any complex problem statement can be done. So definitely a numerical method is nothing but an iterative based method. Definitely there is going to be error, but as compared to these two things, numerical proves to be strong, okay. It is time wise effective, cost wise very much effective, and nowadays all the companies are trying to adopt numerical methods. It's like adopting tools like Ansys or something like that, because all the companies want to put their product first. So that's where they are going to use all these tools, okay. If you take numerical method, basically we have three methods, guys, okay. Basically we have three methods, so listen very carefully. If you have one notes, please take a note of it. The first method is FDM, okay. It is nothing but finite difference method. Finite difference method. The next one is FAM, finite volume method. The third thing is finite. Guys, please don't send me annotation request. It will disturb the whole meeting. Okay. 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 So I'll make it short. FDM, please make a note of it. FEM. FEM. Okay. So these are the basic methodologies which is available in numerical method. Why I'm telling this? Because you would have come across so many softwares, Ansys, Hypermesh, ISMCFD, Pointwise, so many industrial softwares are there. But all the softwares will come under this three approach, okay? Any one of this three approach only. There is nothing more than this, okay? FDM means finite difference method, FEM means finite volume method, FEM means finite element method, okay? In your third year or fourth year, you would be studying finite element method. That is very important paper. So please be sure to go through that very thoroughly. Okay. But as far as CFD problems are concerned, industry is going for finite volume method. Okay. Finite volume method. So before moving on to our practical session, today I'll show you entire process which is involved in CFD, okay. I'll explain you some basic concepts, I'll show you the complete thing how to work on CFD problem, okay. So please listen very carefully. Fine. So we have two things, one is finite volume method, another one is finite element method. The important thing is, guys, in numerical method, we have something called meshing, okay. We have something called meshing. I'll tell you what that mesh exactly means, okay. You'd have come across something called control volume, okay. You'd have come across something called control volume. The main thing which tells about control volume is, for example, if you have a plate, okay, I have a two plates, one I'm going to solve it by FEM method and another one I'm going to solve it by FEM method, okay. How the problem is basically solved. The thing is, first you will have a geometry, guys, okay. So this is your geometry, I'll explain it, I will do all these things in a software, okay. So please listen very carefully. First we have a geometry, okay, geom. When you have a geometry, what we are supposed to do is, I'm supposed to mesh it, okay. I'm supposed to mesh it or discretize it. So it is like I'll discretize the whole volume into small control volumes, okay. Small control volumes. Okay, Just for example, I'm just making it small control volumes. After that, what we will do is we will give a boundary condition. For example, if this face is exposed to 20 degree, I'll give a boundary condition is 20. And for example, in this case, if it is exposed to 20 degree, I'll give 20 degree. But the problem approaches in FEA method, solution is solved in the center of the node. For example, guys, this is the one cell, okay? I am just taking one cell from here. If this is one cell, the problem solution will be calculated in the center of the cell and it will be interpolated to the sides, okay? It will be interpolated to the boundaries. But if you take FEM approach, it is like finite element method, what happens is if you take a single cell, the solutions will be computed in the nodes. The solutions will be computed in each nodes, okay? So this is the major difference between finite volume method and finite element method, okay? Guys, please don't annotate. By mistake, I gave access to one of the student, Mirza Faisal. So please don't annotate Mirza Faisal, okay? So the thing is, in finite volume method, solution will be calculated in the center of the node, and in finite element method, it will be computed in the nodes, okay? So guys, this is the very basic thing, which is all about FEM and FEM. Otherwise, all the equations, all the major stuff will be similar, but this approach will differ, okay? Now, let us go for presentation. I hope now you understood some of the basic things, okay? Industries are going for a tool-based thing just for saving time as well, cost. In the tool-based thing, we have three things, FEM, FEM and FDM. In FEM and FEM, as I told you, then in FEM, finite element method, values will be calculated in the nodes. In finite volume method, values will be calculated in center of the node, I mean center of the cell, okay? Particularly for CFD, all the solvers are going to use finite volume method. Okay, these are the main interview questions because we have so many things, no? FDM and FEM, FDM. So in CFD, we are going to use finite volume method. So that is all about CFD. Okay, so see, in the screen, you can study like computational fluid dynamics, CFD. The science of predicting fluid flow, heat, mass transfer, chemical reaction, and anything. Okay. So by using CFD, you can solve for fluid flow. For example, guys, the major difficulty, for example, if you take a space shuttle, Tesla is modeling a space vehicle which can go to the orbit, release the satellite, and come back to the earth, and it can land vertically in the sea surface, okay? So just assume if the vehicle is coming from outer space into earth surface, there will be an immense heat generation in the surface of the vehicle, okay? That is because of friction between the component and the earth atmosphere. The temperature will be in thousands, okay? Thousands degrees Celsius. So you cannot perform an experimental study in this case, okay? You cannot model a space shuttle. You cannot launch it to the atmosphere, I mean, outer atmosphere. You cannot carry out experiment when it is coming back into Earth surface, okay? That is very costly and near to impossible, okay? So in these cases, CFD, you know, plays a very vital role, okay? It can give you very good solution. It can give you all the major solution which you want to design a thing. Okay, so that is what this particular slides tell you. CFD can give you pressure value, velocity, temperature, force, lift, drag, anything, okay? Anything which you are going to see practically in the equipment. For example, in the lab, you would be carrying out experiments in, you know, for convection, radiation, heat exchanger, so many things you'll be doing in your engineering labs. All the things can be exactly modeled in a software. Solutions can be extracted from the software, and these things can be experimentally validated. Okay, so this is why industries are now preferring to move on to software side. So this is what I was telling, guys. Okay, so this is what I was telling. See, this is just a tube. It is meshed. You can see control volume is mentioned here. This is where you will define inlet. The other end will be outlet. These things will be wall. Okay, these things will be wall, and the solution will be solved in each and every cell. Can I get an answer? You can just post it in the chat. So in this particular problem, if you are solving by FEM method, where the values will be calculated? This is just a bent tube. I'm going to solve this particular case in CFD, where the values will be calculated. Guys, anyone? Yeah, so where the values will be calculated? Guys, the thing is, only when you know these things, very basic things, I can go for tools. I have all the tool switched on. So after telling all these basics, I can directly move on to my tools. But before that, I just want to check that all the students are listening. Guys, can you please tell me? At the center of the node, very good. Okay, yeah, good. So values will be computed in the center of the cell. Okay, fine. Okay, guys. So, okay. So this is some of the approach. Okay. So in the screen you can see, guys. Please mute yourself, or I'll mute. Okay. So the thing is, this is the domain. Okay. So this is the domain. For example, if you take a thermal power plant, nuclear power plant,